My name is Amy. I've been with the Types actually a year next month. And I'm a graduate from Sunnyside High School. And so since I've had more experience in this, I go around and I help Sarah with some of the workshops and stuff. So, and it's kind of become a huge part of who I am. It never made sense to me. We were not gods. We cannot be born of just man or just woman, so why didn't we worship both? See, I like to think like the scientist my mother wishes I was, that in this world you cannot have one without the other. You cannot have up without down, earth without sky, right without wrong, or order without chaos. So why was there God without goddess? See, I have both. I have a mother and a father. I have this earth and this sky that keep me grounded here. So you can keep your leather-bound books and your door-to-door paper pamphlets, because I don't need them. You can keep your gods. I don't need them. I have two of my own. You can keep your leather-bound books and your door-to-door paper pamphlets, because I was taught to worship with that material object. But I'm not dethroning your God. Now, I'm not saying I don't believe in him, because I very much do. I'm just choosing not to fear him and to believe that if he was as loving as I was taught he was, he let me choose my own path. So while we sit side by side in these wooden pews in your stone temples, witches don't do well inside stone walls. While we pray for sins we will commit again before next Sunday, I just pray for a temporary asylum in this temple in which I don't feel right if I feel like myself. Which is why Wiccans never had churches. See, we don't pray by leather-bound verses. We don't cover the earth in plastic towels or leather cushions before we put our knees to it. We were born from it and we were returned to it. We pray by this air that is the giver of life and water that is the sustainer of it. We pray by this fire that was breathed into us by your God. But you called it magic, bound it in leather and tossed it away. Did you ever learn the morals of the stories you taught your children? See, I learned that harm to another in revenge is the greatest sin. Yet even for his brother, Cain, you avenged sevenfold. Out of the sight of the one, away in this land you must go. I learned that in this life, I alone am responsible for my mistakes and my burdens. Yet it is because of Eve that I know the pain of sin. Toss me the apple, I'll savor each bite. And deep inside, we might know Adam was right. Did you ever learn the morals of the stories you taught your children? Well, I did, which is why I closed my ears off to leather-bound verses, and I rose from plastic tiles and leather cushions, and I stepped away from wooden pews and stone temples, because witches don't do well inside stone walls.